I mean, think about it. Who else can do that but the master that you and I serve? Okay? All right. But Tab, anybody online? Okay. All right. So here we go. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 13. All right. I know Sister Holston, she wanted this last week. But we had to finish 12 first. So now, Paul is going to talk about love the superior way. So think about it. Love the superior way. Maybe not love how we think about it. Because again, God's love is different than man's love. Okay? Because somebody might love you today and they might throw you away tomorrow. But aren't you glad that God's love is not like that? Aren't you glad that he has an agape love towards us? I mean, think about that. His love is a love that's far superior than any other form of love that we'll know in this life. And it's a maturing component as well. So here we are. I need a volunteer to go ahead and read verses 1-3.
What do I speak with the tongues of men and
Somebody else's needs before your love. Love is putting somebody else's blessings
Checked every single box. And so it's like no wonder, you know, it is our desire to be like Christ, because he is the perfect example of what love is.
Of God's presence, spiritual gifts will come to an end because we will no longer need them. When we're going where Jesus is, you won't need all this other stuff. Now, again, he's the one who has blessed all of us to have the gifts. But when we are going to be with him, we won't need that. Okay? Because he will be there. We will be in his very presence, okay? And again, spiritual gifts will come to an end because we will no longer need them, but not love. Love, in verse 8, never ends. His love for us never ends. So then therefore, the scripture is right because he loves me and you so much. Oh, Sister Dave. I believe that's John 3:16, what you just said, Sister Dave. Because he loved me and you, he gave. He paid the ultimate sacrifice for me and you because he loves us. Kind of reminds me of that song that used to be played here. He loves you because he loves you because he loves you. Okay, thank you. His love never ends. When the perfect comes, because when we go to be with him, that's where perfect is, okay? When the perfect comes, the partial will come to an end. Huh? When the perfect comes. The partial we don't need. When you got perfect, why do you need partial? Huh? When you have the real thing, why you don't need anything else? In verse 10, Deke talked about by perfect. Paul's referring to spiritual maturity. I want to say it might have been somebody who said it on Sunday or lied the first Sunday in the year. What they're working for is a well done. I think that was Sister Blunt, because she said it, what we're working for, y'all, is a well done. Think about it. The sovereign God of the universe, one day to tell you or me, well done, thy good and thy faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. Huh? I'm not talking about one of the apostles or one of the prophets. I'm talking about the sovereign God of the universe telling you and me that. Perfect, referring to spiritual maturity. The more a person grows in spiritual maturity, the less dependent one is on the particular gifts of prophecy and tongues. Again, we talked about it. We've seen some spiritual growth in folks throughout this congregation. We mentioned it on Sunday. And here's what happens. Now many of us are in a joyous mode because we can see the growth in others. Nobody's sitting around saying, man, I can't believe so-and-so growing spiritually and I'm not. That's, think about it. That would be a selfish thing to get upset with somebody because they're growing in the Lord. We should be happy when we see others growing. Because here, there used to be a deacon here, Deacon Donovan, you say, if you catch on fire, somebody will watch you, come and watch you burn. And again, I almost want to say it's like it's contagious. And it starts to spread, especially when you have a church that wants to grow spiritually. Thank you. It didn't say nothing about perfect vessels, Sister Holston. He just wants willing vessels. Now, what does that mean? That means we got to say, okay, am I willing to spend that time that it takes for growth? Am I praying for the spiritual growth? Are we, when we come together, if we're here, because we know this, True Light, so only some things will come through what? Praying and fasting. Fasting means, and prayer, right, means we want to say, Lord, we're willing to give up some things to get closer to you. And guess what? When the Lord starts to see a congregation willing to get closer to him, Sister Dave, things start to happen. And hey, when you start praying, and then even when you think, because it's only us who thinks he's forgotten about the stuff we've been praying for, and then when he starts to do some things and he starts to move in some ways you're not expecting, then sometimes you just got to sit there and say, wait a minute. He heard those prayers. Thank you. And then here's the thing, though. He answers them when he sees fit. Or like we said on Sunday. Again, I use the example with Lexi. She want to drive. Ain't no way in the world I'm going to put her out there on that road. And heck, she almost gave me some whiplash out there in that parking lot. But I can put her on a parking lot where there's not other folks around and start to teach the process. Well, guess what? With us, with our saved selves, the Lord has to still teach us. We have to say, Lord, I'm dependent on you. Lord, I don't know how you're going to make this happen. I don't know how. And sometimes, right, I'm still like, Lord, can I be honest with y'all? Lord, I don't understand why you put me back where you put me again. And then I started to say, okay, Lord, it must be something that you want me to learn. Now, I'll be honest with y'all too. Lord, help me to learn it quick so I can get out of this. But that's not up to me when he lets me out. Thank you, Sister Dave. Again, with my type A personality, right? Not my will. Thank you, Sister Dave. But his will. Listen at this. Again, the more a person grows in spiritual maturity, the less dependent one is on particular gifts of prophecy and tongues. Because Deke told you, at some point, tongues are going to cease. I think he read that. We know in part, and we prophesied in part. But again, when we go to be with the Lord, you don't need that prophecy because you with him. Huh? Hey, y'all, I get it. I know we still got loved ones here. I get it. We got some of us have loved ones that went on to glory. Yes? But think about this. To be where Jesus is, there's some things we don't have to worry about when we are there with him. Huh? Again, think about what it's going to be like. And not only think about what it's going to be like, think about that you're going to be there for eternity. Go ahead, D, read verses 11 and 12 for us.
When I was a child, I spoke as a child.
Oh, wait, D, hold on. Now you telling me, Paul said, when I was a child, thought as a child. I spoke as a child. I even did some childish things. Some of us grown and do childish stuff, and we'll never admit it. Especially not to young people, Giovanni. There are some folks who'll walk around and say they never did anything. Now, there are some folks, and I heard a lady, she's our newest board member. She said she was a wild child running wild. Now, sometimes folks like that, when they talk to young people, that have been going through some things, Sister Day, those young people can relate to them because they can say, oh, I kind of was like you once upon a time. But I believe what Paul said again. Go ahead, D. Keep going.
I understood as a child.
I understood as a child. Okay.
I thought as a child.
Mm-hmm.
But when I became a man, put away childish things.
Wait, Deke, stop right there. See, in my mind, I still hear Bishop Jones saying there's a difference between a man and a male. Huh? There's a difference between a man and a male. See, a man will get up every day. He'll make sure he's going to work. He'll make sure that household is taken care of because he's the benevolent leader. All right? Now, a male might be still there with his feet up playing that video game. Okay? But a man, there's a difference. Huh? As I look at this man right here, I know there was plenty of days before he retired, and it was cold out there like it was today, but guess what? He didn't stay at home. Huh? It was plenty of days. You didn't want to go. Deke, when I look back there at you, with them ones you got at the house right now, you really can't stay at home. Again, Paul is saying, but when I became a man, I put away childish things because I have responsibility. Huh? Thank you. Because I believe there's a scripture that said if a man don't work, he shouldn't eat. I know some people might not like it, but it says it. Huh? Could say some other stuff, but I'm gonna stop right there. Because again, maybe some of our young men aren't seeing men, they're seeing males, they're not seeing men. There's a difference. Because our kids will emulate what they grow up seeing, believe it or not. Keep going, D.
For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then face to face.
Wait. What, we talk about some reflections? Face to face. Y'all see how this coincides? Mm-hmm. Keep going, D.
Now I know in part, but when I shall know just as I also am known. And now, abide in faith, mm-hmm. hope,
yes.
love, these three, but the greatest of them is love.
The greatest of them is love. Again, to recap some of these verses he just read, a child speaks, thinks, and reasons as a child, right? So, Dave, I see you, that youngest grandson of yours, and you could just see the energy. I mean, one Sunday we was up here, and Minister Jermar said, oh, he going to be a fast little guy. Because I'm telling you, he got from there to over to where that candy was, like lickety-split, right? But again, his excitement, because they know after service, there's a box over there full of stuff they like. See? Thank you. Now, what Sister Dave might have to periodically do is limit how many pieces of candy he gets, because if he already has that much energy naturally, once he gets some sugar in him, he gonna be all over the place. And then he gotta go home, right, Sister Dave? So again, but a man has grown in maturity and put aside childish things. Our Christian goal is spiritual maturity, whether you're a man or a woman. The goal is spiritual maturity, full maturity. Again, like we said on Sunday, I will never see anybody give a little baby a T-bone steak. That baby can't handle it, okay? But when you get a 16-year-old, a 17-year-old like I have, that joker eat you out of house and home. Deacon White, you know what I'm talking about, because you got a 15-year-old back there. But again, full maturity will only finally occur in God's glorious presence. We talked about that earlier. But we are to progressively mature now. Progressively mature now. Currently, our experience is like looking at a reflection in a dim mirror. I believe that's what you said, D.
Yes,
but eventually, we will see face to face. Even as Paul said, even as I'm fully known to God. Now, one day I will fully realize as God meant me to be known. Oh, okay. That's verses 12, right? And it will be made clear. Here. I believe there's part of that scripture that says, I know what we all call here, but I believe there's a stone, Deacon. We used to sing this song, said, I got a new name over in glory. And it's mine. I know what they call each of us down here, but I wonder what the Lord says he's going to call you. But we got to get there, okay? Now, in verse 13, again, as Paul ends this chapter, these three remain. Deke told you what they are. Faith, very important, because I believe without faith, it's impossible, Sister Dave, to please him, right? Okay, so faith is important. Hope, if we don't have hope, I believe Deacon Guy used to say this, we will be men and women most miserable. We have to have hope, okay, in him. And love. But again, Dick said the greatest of these is love. Think about it. In eternity, you will no longer need faith because you will have sight. In eternity, you will no longer need hope because your expectations and anticipations will have been met and exceeded. Think about it. Your hope has been met and exceed it when you get there. But love will characterize our eternal relationship with God. It will continue since God is love. I need somebody to go, as we get ready to close, to 1 John 4:8, and we'll see what it says. Again, 1 John 4:8.
Say 1 John 4:8?
Yes, sir.
He who does not love does not know God, for God is love.
Read it again, D.
He who does not love does not know God, for God is love.
It tells us God is love. So, Sister Dave, back to one of your points tonight. Because he's the perfect example of love. But if we don't know him, we don't know love. Or here, without him, we cannot love. It's impossible for us to do it on our own. We don't have the capacity. Here, we don't have the intelligence. We don't have the intellect. Whatever adjective you want to use, we don't have it without him. It's not in our makeup. But with him, though, we can love. Wait, Mrs. Holston. You telling me with God, I can love even though somebody cussing me out? Huh? Yeah. And when I want to say something back, oh, wait a minute, Sister Dave, they hit me on that one? Oh. Huh? Yeah. And sometimes, guess what? That's what he has to do. Because he's love. And when you want to lash back out, what he'll do is say, come on with me. Huh? Why? Because he loves us. And he paid it all for you and me. Now here, Sister Dave, you might remember this. There was a song that was sung. We was up in Akron one evening. And then we were singing this song, and then part of it said, now that's love. Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. Think about it. He hung his head, and then he died. Again, that's love. But again, but the part that I really love, they said, that's not how the story ends. But 3 days later, he rose again. Now that's love. That's love. To endure everything, think about it. To endure being smacked. To endure the scourging. To endure carrying that cross down the street. And the women were weeping. And for him to say, don't weep for me. And then to have spikes driven in his hands for you and me. Again, that's love. To have spikes driven in his feet for you and me. That's love. To be pierced in the side for you and me. That's love. To be ridiculed while he was up there. To be forsaken, to be betrayed with a kiss, that's love. Oh, Sister Dave, think about that. Forgive them, for they know not what they do. Again, that's love. And again, we said it in Sunday school. It was Minister Dave. The thing would be, I'm not going to say it exactly how he said it, how many of us would have went through that? Now, Sister Dave, you might have went through it for your daughter and your grandsons and some other loved ones. Some of us might have thought about it.
Oh, yeah, for my kids.
Yeah, some of y'all. But here, to go through what he went through for the whole world? Thank you. Past, present, and future. That's love.
To be born to do that.
Correct. Yes. So that's chapter 13, y'all.
Yes. Yes. You know, the one thing I do like, and I thought it was important, was verse 13. Now, my mine's the New King James, and it talks about abide in faith, hope, and love. And I think the first word is extremely important for us. I think kind of go over it rather quickly sometimes, and we got to realize abiding, when you look at the word abide, it means remain, but remain in a long period of time. So you know, he's telling us we need to abide in faith, we need to abide in hope, and then we need to abide in love. We need to be in it. We need to remain in it. You know, does that make sense?
Yeah. Because in John, he talks about us abiding in him. To use that word, Sister Dave, if I'm not mistaken, to abide in him. Because again, if we're the branches, we have to abide in him to get the nutrients that we need. To use the tree analogy, right?
That's
true. All right? Okay. And if we're anchored in him, just like the base of the tree, what happens? The roots go deep, and they go deep to make the tree sturdy. And to get the nutrients that will come up in the branches. And then also there's parts of us that that might not be like him, and then they need to be cut away so that we can get the maximum of what he wants out of me and you, so we can produce much fruit. Here, Deke can tell you some lessons about making sure things are cut properly. Because I'm pretty sure he'll tell you if a limb, any limbs he's ever dealt with, if he looked up and said it's dead. Here, Deke has, I think it's a lopper, Deke. Am I saying that right? One of the devices that you use to cut limbs? A lopper?
Yes.
Oh, see, look at that. See, I learned something, Sister Holston. And what he'll do is he'll see it. Oh, that thing is dead. And guess what he gonna do? He gonna cut it. That's right, Deke. Now, the tree might say, don't cut me. But he gonna say, you not producing, I'm gonna cut this limb so those nutrients that's been going there can be redirected. Yeah. All right. Anything online, Brother Tavon? All right. So we thank the Lord for tonight. Sister Holston, we got it in. any prayer requests as we get ready to close?
Yes, could you pray for my family? My brother's daughter passed on yesterday.
Oh.
No, the day before yesterday. His oldest daughter died.
Okay.
Pray for Roosevelt, Kelly, and family.
Let's bow our heads. Dear Lord, we've come to the end of a Bible study. We hold up the family of Roosevelt Kelly. We hold up that family that has recently lost a loved one. Father, we know that death is always an intrusion. But also we know, as the Apostle Paul said, to be absent in this body is to be present with the Lord. Lord, we ask that you provide comfort to the bereaved family. Lord, we ask that you help us, Lord, to continue to have a desire to want to study your holy and divine word. Lord, we ask for spiritual growth, spiritual maturity. Lord, we ask that you strengthen us through your word, encourage us, enlighten us, illumine us, help our light so shine before mankind so that they can see our good works, and we want you to be glorified, our Heavenly Father. Now, as we get ready to leave this place, but never thy presence, we ask that you bless everybody who joined us online. We ask that you bless everybody who joined us in the sanctuary. We ask again, keep us safe until the next appointed time. We thank you, Lord, and we praise you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And again, for those of you who joined us online, we thank you for joining us tonight. Sunday school starts on Sundays at 8:45. Morning worship starts at 10 o'clock. And on Wednesdays, we have two Bible study sessions, one at noon and one at 6:45. Have a blessed night.